tempo of rehearsing and recording, and just getting the right focus at the right time. Unfortunately, this situation now with this music having not arrived is really changes all that.
So this is the situation we're in at the moment. I've completed my 6 arrangements, and today Matt Clifford, who was contracted to do 2 arrangements, has not handed his scores in.
Your presence is eagerly awaited. They're all dying to meet you. Okay, right. Do you want to know where the back door is?
I'm told that Matt's computer is broken down. The moral of this story is write everything out by hand. So we've got a situation where we've got the whole orchestra at £100 a minute just sitting around. Peter Scholes has got 5 minutes to look over the score, and then he's got to conduct it. He's never seen the school before, and I feel for him in this situation.
Thank you, everybody.
Matt Clifford, he'd worked with the Stones, he toured with them on their Steel Wheels tour, so you know, there was a link there. He'd actually been part of the band for a while, so I thought that was quite important to have someone, you know, who had worked with the band previously. After choosing the arrangers, I then asked the arrangers which ones, you know, they fancied doing, really. So it ended up with Jazz picking 6, John 4, and Matt 1.
It's often forgotten that the great composers of the past, who we always quote, the Mozarts and Beethovens, were incredibly commercial and wrote virtually everything they did for money and wrote to order. You know, Vivaldi would be told, oh, I want a string quartet, or Haydn, you know, we're having some people over for dinner next week, could you knock something up? And he would do it. Or we want a requiem on Sunday, my uncle's died. And, you know, you can't put classical music or serious music on this pedestal, which is where it's come now.
You could have picked any producer and any arranger to do Rolling Stones, you know, songs with an orchestra. But I think because of my knowledge of their music and my appreciation of their music as well, I wanted to make sure that it was interpreted in a definite way, that it wasn't just like Muzak. I wanted to make it symphonic, classical, but still keeping, you know, their tune in there, obviously. And I think that picking these 3 arrangers, I think that's what I've done.
Dandelion's a lot of fun, and it was an actual gem of inspiration when they put the kids' choir on.
Dandelions, don't tell no lies. Dandelions will make you wise. Tell me if she loves or cries. Blow away, dandelions.
Melodic songs like Dandelion, a lot of those tunes you don't really appreciate how precise the melodies were until you hear it with an orchestra. It's quite wonderful. It's difficult to imagine a Rolling Stones song with an orchestra.
based on that. So going back to the days that I used to listen to everything that came out with. And I used to sing this song in my father's pub, so it was absolutely thrilling for me to be able to do it, and you know, to do it in an album with so many other singers that I admire.
I don't know if Rolling Stones fans do want the classical touch. They're going to get it whether they like it or not.
It's been, you know, 3 days of incredibly intense music making. That's been one of the most rewarding things I've done in my life. It's been such a joy to work with all of the people involved in the project, from the producer, the arrangers, the musicians in the orchestra, just the whole team. It's been just fantastic, warm experience actually. I'll treasure it for the rest of my life.
I love the orchestra with absolute passion. I think it's the 90s are going to see the orchestra come almost supersede rock groups, I think.
Sometimes I think the rock and rollers are more conservative than the classical musicians. I think it's possible that the rock and roll purists are going to be more upset about this album than the classical ones, actually.